Hi guys, welcome to Selenium Automation Testing. So today in this video we are going to learn about how to automate or how to scan barcode stickers, barcode images like. So this is the demo web application. So this is the barcode sticker. Okay, so based on the requirement, developer will create the barcode sticker. Okay, and it is our task to scan to verify that after scanning this barcode sticker we get only this string value. Okay, so this is the requirement and developer is created this barcode sticker. Now we need to verify that after scanning this barcode sticker we get only this string value. Okay, so let's start with the practical how to automate how to scan barcode stickers. Okay, so our expectation is after scanning this sticker we get this string value abc-abc-123. So this is the web element, right, which is present on the web page. So I have written the code up to launch the URL. So we are going to find this image on the web page first of all. So we use web element is equal to driver dot find element by dot xpath. Okay, and we create the xpath for the image. Actually barcode sticker is created by using image tag. Okay, just right click on the barcode sticker and click on the inspect button. Okay, so our barcode sticker is comes inside the image tag and it have only one attribute src. So just create the xpath by using this value. Image is a tag name and src is an attribute. Just press Ctrl F, double forward slash and then tag name image @ src is equal to, I will provide the src value, right click and inspect, again right click and click on the edit @html. Okay, just copy this value, copy and paste here. See guys, one of one. Okay, just copy this complete xpath and paste over here. So this is the our web element. So after finding the element we need to take the URL of the particular web element. Okay, this is the URL which is comes inside the src attribute. So Selenium provide one method, we use element dot get attribute and we provide attribute name as a src and it will return one string value, right? So I will store inside this string str is equal to element dot get attributes. So this is the code. From now we write the code how to automate barcode sticker. Okay, this is the most basic code. Okay, so after taking the this URL inside this reference variable str. First thing is we need to download some jar files. Okay, like this one, we need to download these three jar files. I will provide the URL of this web pages. Okay, you just open and download. Okay, I will provide the URL of these jar files in my video's description box. So after importing these jar files in our project, we use URL class. Okay, this is the URL class. Okay, I will show you URL. URL classes comes by the three different packages, but we need to take it from java.net package. So we use URL. URL is equal to new URL. Okay, and we provide the URL which is present inside this reference variable. So I will provide our str here. Okay, so this is the first task. Okay, just create the reference variable and then create the object. Now it's time to perform second task. Now we need to take help from the buffered image class. So we use buffered image img is equal to, sorry, we use buffered image img is equal to image io dot read. So it will read our image. Okay, and we pass our URL here. URL. Okay, so we are done with the second task also. Now it's time to perform third task. Now after performing these two tasks, we need to take help from the luminance source. Okay, luminance source ls is equal to new buffered image luminance source. Okay, luminance source ls is equal to new buffered image luminance source first method. Just take it first method and provide our image here, img. Okay, now it's time to complete. Now it's time to perform fourth task. So now we are going to use from the binary bitmap. Okay, so we use binary bitmap b is equal to new binary bitmap. Okay, new binary bitmap, and inside this constructor we create one object of hybrid binarizer. New hybrid binarizer. Okay, and we pass our luminance source reference variable ls over here. See guys, this is not a rocket science. Okay, I know this code is little bit tricky, but after understanding you definitely get some idea. Okay, only 4 to 5 lines of code here. Okay, so after writing this fourth line of code, let's jump to the last line, the fifth line. Okay, fifth task is, now we have this hybrid binarizer and we provide the luminance source over here. So now we use result class. Okay, result. So let's take it from the google.zxing. result. Okay, result is equal to new multi-format. Okay, I will show you multi-format reader. Multi-format reader. Okay, where is it? Is, let me check. Multi-format reader, this one. Okay, both class, both packages are same. Let's take it from anyone. The first one, multi-format reader dot decode, because our text, this text is decoded in this code, right? Encoding and decoding, right? So from this decodation we take it again from our actual string value. So we use decode and we provide the binary bitmap. So we take first one binary bitmap and we provide b over here. We need to add some exception. Okay, yeah, throw declarations, save for the main method also, because we called this method inside the main method, right? Just add. So now we just need to print our text. Okay, so we use system.out.println. We use result dot get text, right? From this decode we are taking the text. Get text method is there. Control shift F and control C. So let me run one time, then I will explain you one more time. Just save. I have called this method inside the main method. It's time to execute. Just save and click on the run button. Only 5 line of code. Okay. Error has occurred. Please check your installation and try again. Okay. Check. Control shift F. Control save. Okay. Let me run. Okay. Okay. Java exception has occurred. Which one? Let me open console. नेटिव मेथड, ओके। सो लेट मी चेंज द मेथड नेम, दिस वन टेस्ट ओनली, राइट। Only test, yeah. Control Shift F and Control Save. Let me run. Still error. I don't know the reason. Just a minute. I will solve this, and I will start it. Cannot enter it. Okay. Just a minute, guys. I will pause the video. Yeah. Hi, guys. Welcome again. Okay, so we need to add only these two jar files, okay, the core 1.6 and Java SE, okay. We don't need to download, we don't need to import this jar file, okay. I will provide only URL for these two jar files, okay. We don't need to worry about it. So let me close this one, okay. So this is our script. So this is the file line of code, okay. First thing is we need to get the web element, our URL, this one, okay. By taking the web element, we use this one method, find elements, okay. After taking the web element, we use this method, get attributes, to get the URL, because URL is comes inside the src attribute. So we provide attribute name src and we take the URL, okay. After taking the URL, we pass this URL inside the URL constructor. So we create the object for the URL class, okay. Then we pass our image to the buffered image, image.readme. So it will read our URL, it will read our image, okay. Then we use luminance source, this is the class, okay. I will show you, this is the class, okay. This is the abstract class. Then we create the reference, then we create the object for the buffered image luminance source, and we pass our image to this constructor. Then we use binary bitmap, okay. Binary bitmap, b is equal to new binary bitmap, new hybrid binarizer. Then this, the text is decoded, right. The text is decoded in this format, in this lines format. So we need to again it take in the normal text. So we use result is equal to new multi format reader dot decode, and we pass this binary bitmap b over here, and then we use result dot get text method, okay. Control Shift F and Control Save. Let me run this code, okay. I will show you. So the expected output is, after scanning this barcode sticker, we get abc-abc-123. This is the expectation. Let me close this one. So this is our expectation string, okay. Let me run and see. Just wait for the execution. It will open Chrome, then launch our URL, okay. Chrome is opened, it will launching our URL now, okay. Still launching, okay, done. Now let me scroll down. So this is our barcode and the text is abc-abc-123. So let me open our Eclipse. See guys, this is the text abc-abc-123, okay. Let me close this one. I will show you with this example. Hi, this is Pawan, okay. So let me inspect this barcode sticker now. Just right click and click on the inspect button. We just need to change the URL. So just copy this URL now. Just click on the edit as HTML and copy this value and change the XPath. src is equal to, everything is changed, we need to change only this URL. Paste and save. So expectation is, after scanning this barcode sticker, we get this one. Hi, this is Pawan. Okay, so just press Ctrl Shift F and Ctrl save and run. Now it will print, hi, this is Pawan. Okay, our web page is launched properly. So the expectation output is, hi, this is Pawan. Okay, let me open Eclipse. So this is the text, hi, this is Pawan, right? So let me inspect this QR code. Okay, but we don't have any text here, right? We don't have any text. Okay, so I will create the new video for this QR code also, because in this example we have proof that after scanning this barcode sticker we get this one, but in this example we don't have any get, right? So let me create one more video based on this QR code. Okay, so just focus on this barcode. So this is the example of how to scan barcode sticker. Okay, so after taking this text, okay, I close this. Okay, no problem. So after taking this text, we need to verify that the particular scanner, that the particular barcode will return only this text, hi, this is Pawan, or ABC-ABC-123, or any price. Okay, so to do this we need to use this code URL. Okay, this one. Okay, let me, okay, just a minute, I will resume it. Okay guys, just a minute. Okay guys, welcome back. So let's try to automate this QR code also, because we have already written the code for the barcode sticker. I think for the barcode sticker and QR code we have same code. Okay, so just inspect this QR code. Just right click on the QR code and click on the inspect button. Okay, this QR code is also made by image tags. Just let me set up. Okay, so again right click on the QR code and click on the inspect button. Okay, so this is the XPath. So I will change the XPath, edit as HTML this time. Okay, again it comes inside the image tag and attribute name is src, same. So just copy this value and paste here. Image tag, src attribute, everything is same, just we need to change this value. Okay, just a minute, I will change it, right? Yeah, control paste and control save, control shift F, control save. So let me close this one, I will show you here. So I don't know what is the text we get after scanning this QR, because in this example we get ABC-ABC-123, and for this barcode we got this, hi, this is Pawan, but here we don't have any text, right? Just try to scan, see what will we get. Control Shift F and Control Save. Let me run this one. Okay, execution is started. Launching the URL. Okay, still launching. Okay, launched. Let me down web page. Okay, so let me open Eclipse, because we don't have any text right here. Let me open Eclipse. Okay guys, so this is the text. Welcome to Selenium. See? Okay, this is the text. After scanning this barcode, after scanning this QR code, we got this text. Welcome to Selenium. Right? I will show you one more time for all this barcode and QR. Okay, let me inspect this one. Just click on the inspect. Okay, just copy this SRC value. Just right click, click on the edit as HTML. Copy this value, copy and change here. This is the example of barcode. Okay, the first barcode. Control paste. Okay, for this the expectation output is ABC-ABC-123, right? Let me run this one. This is the first barcode which we already covered, but I will show you one more time. Okay, execution is started. Okay, web page is launching now. Let me scroll down the web page. So the expectation is we get ABC-ABC-123. So let's open the Eclipse. We get ABC-ABC-123. Okay, now it's time to take this one. Hi, this is Pawan. Let me inspect this one. Hi, this is Pawan, and copy the edit as HTML. Control F and paste here. Control paste and save. Let me run this one. This time we get hi, this is Pawan. Okay, the second barcode. So let me scroll down the web page. So I think this is the problem, because each and every time we need to manually scroll down the web page. Okay, hi, this is Pawan. Okay, so yeah, we get the text, complete text, but we need to manually scroll down the web page. So what is the solution for this? Okay, so we use JavaScript executor. I will show you how it's work. Okay, let me change the URL first of all for this barcode sticker. QR code inspect. I will show you how to scroll down your web page until your web page is not appear on this on the screen. Okay, control and copy. I will show you quickly. It take hardly 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, let me remove this one first. So just paste and save. So each and every time we need to manually scroll down our web page. Okay, after launching the web page, we are still here. Okay, we need to manually scroll down by using arrow down key, right? So how to ignore it? So we use JavaScript executor. I will show you. JavaScript executor is interface. Okay, JavaScript executor, JS is equal to, as I said, JavaScript executor is an interface. So we are not able to create the object, so we use driver. So we typecast our driver into JavaScript executor, and we use one method, js.execute script. Okay, js.executeScript. Now here we write the code for the scroll down your web page. So we use arguments 0 dot okay scroll into view. Scroll into view and we provide true, means it will scroll down our web page. True means it will scroll down our web page until this web element is not appear on the screen, right? So we I will pass our element here, control shift F and control save. So after launching the URL, it will scroll down our web page until our web element, which means our QR code is not appear, we are not able to see on the screen. So it will scroll down until we are able to see our web element, our QR code. So press control shift F and control save. I will show you how it's work. It will automatically scroll down up to QR code. Just wait for the minute, I will show you. It will automatically scroll down, okay. Okay, the page is launching now, okay. Still launching, okay. See guys, automatically it will click on the arrow button for the scroll down. Now I am able to see my QR code. Now my task is just open this Eclipse. See, welcome to Selenium. Okay, if I will write false here, true or false, so at this time it will not scroll down. I will show you. This time it will not scroll down until your web element is appear on the screen, because we passed a value false here, right? I will show you the difference, the actual difference between scroll down true and false. Okay, just a minute, I will show you. Okay, it will maximize. Okay, I think we got no. Yeah, this time it will not scroll down automatically. Still launching. Okay, I think I don't know the difference between these two, but I will pass false over here, but it will also scroll down. Okay, no problem. Use welcome, we get this one. Okay, welcome to Selenium. So let me close this one first of all. Close all these three browsers. So this is the code to scroll down up until your web element is not appear on the screen. Okay, this is the feature provided by the JavaScript executor interface. So I will make it true, control shift F and control C. Okay, so I will create the new video for this JavaScript executor with the new features, just like scroll into view, draw border. Okay, and in my upcoming video I will cover this true and false also, because this is the video for the automate QR code, barcode stickers, right? So I hope guys you get some idea from this video. This is the only just 5 lines of code. Okay, you need to remember only this 5 lines. This is not the rocket science. Okay, just this 5 lines code, and we need to download 2 jar files. I will provide the URL for the jar files also. So I hope guys you get some idea from this video, how to automate, how to scan QR code and barcode stickers. If you really like this video, then please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for watching this video guys. Thank you.